Hi, I got something vintage today for you guys. I got this radio a couple of years ago from a friend of mine. He didn't have any use of it and it was in the way at his home. But then it worked. But recently I tried to turn it on and there was some kind of popping sound, so I think it's broken. It's too bad, but because this nice vintage device, it's quite high quality receiver from them. So if you have a look, it has a signal strength meter. Here you can choose between AM, SSB and CW. Has some fine tuning for the SSB signal, some sound settings, high and low filter. This is the tuning knob, and this is the band knob. The range was between 3 and 16 megahertz. So when I just had it. I just listened to some amateur radio stations. Just put it a big wire between my room and it worked quite well. But yeah, I had it no time. And so look how big it is. Yeah, someone just put a wire on it for 220 volts. Yeah, I weighed it. It's about 16 kilograms. It's a lot. So, well, I already took off the screws. So let's look what's inside. Well guys, here it is. A real valve or tube. How do you say it? I like to say valve. Radio. Here's the big tunable capacitor. You can see it here. And well, let me take this off and film it for you close by, because it's really really nice. If you can see this, it has some aluminium caps on it, so it should, I think it's because it's military grade, so the tubes won't fall out while moving, I think. Yeah, it's quite nice. Yeah, more tubes like this. If you can see it, all with the caps on it. There are some tunable coils, I think. In here, some more tunable stuff. It's labeled. Yeah, there's the for the tuning. If you can see this. Oh, it's for the band. The band selecting. But yeah, well, let's see the other side. Oh here, yeah. I think this is just serviceable. Parts in here. Yeah, that's nice. Some big high power resistors, some caps. Oh, under here you can see the connectors for the valves tubes. But here, okay. Oh, I think I found the problem. Here is one, a white tube. Oh, there it is. Yeah, it's broken. Okay, problem found. But there's no writing on it. That's a shame. I cannot replace this. Well. Oh, cool. Inside a tube. Yeah. Okay. Well, problem found, but not repairable for me. So, what's in here? Some big two transformers, one big one, one smaller one. What is this? Oh, a big cap. I think this remains. Yeah, 330 volts. I think this is some kind of filter system for the high voltage for the tubes. Yeah, what is this? Oh, great. This, what does it say? Hard to see. Oh, there it is. 100 kilocycles per second. So this is a crystal. It's a crystal tube. I never seen this. Nice. It's really, really nice. Oh yeah, you can see it. 100 kilocycles per second. So it's a 100 kilohertz crystal. Yeah, you can see it. This is one side and this is the other side. It goes here. There is no, how do you say it? No filament in this. So I think it's just a crystal and the tube is for holding it in place so it won't shake or something. Quite nice. Really, really nice part. Oh, the glass in here. Well, not a transformer, more tubes. Well, I'm not into tubes, so I can't say a lot about them. But it's nice to see some tubes. I don't know what it means, all this. Yeah. Well, it's broken. Maybe sometimes I make a whole high voltage transformer and try to make x-rays or something. Yeah, more analog stuff. Only analog stuff here. Really, really nice. Yeah, I'm gonna open this one. I want to look inside of it. Well, that's awkward. There's nothing in there. But there's something in the middle there, on the end, which I can't see here. Well, there are a lot of compartments. Mod record. So it's modded. Oscillator. Ow, the glass. Yeah. Oscillator, band, mixer, aerial. Interesting. Yeah, just take it open. Well, after about 30 screws, I noticed that it's quite hard to open this compartment here. I thought, well, I unscrew this and I screw all these and I unscrew all these. You see, it's under there. I can't open it that easy, so I won't bother. I think it's just there are no tubes or something. So more tubes, as you see. Oh, it's upside down. Oh yeah, oh dear. My table. Well, yeah. Well, maybe there's some more to open. Yeah. Oh. Oh, it's heavy. Really, really heavy. Oh yeah, there's the part. It's a reception set R210. If you want some information about it, you can Google it. But yeah, I tried it. I only found one website. Yeah, but it's old. What's it? Smart Record. I don't know what it is. But yeah, there it is. Really, really old, vintage, military-like radio. Which, well, yeah, is broken. I hate that. Oh yeah, you can see it was broken while it was on. Because that white stuff. I think, well, yeah. It's the filament which burned with the oxygen on it. In it. Well, yeah. Too shame. It's a shame. But there's no writing on it. Why? I never saw a tube without a writing on it. Damn. More tubes. Long tube. Oh, yeah. I already showed that. Here's one. Oh yeah. Yeah, like this. There's just white writing on it. It's a nice one. Yeah, but oh yeah. This is a big one. Nice. Whoa. Come on, focus, focus. AU7, made in England. 4B3, well, here. Yeah. Oh, here, CV491. Well, the paint is going off. Maybe. From heating up and cooling down and heating up. Oh, yeah. Well, I don't know more about to say about this one. Despite the fact it's broken. Well, I removed all the holding caps from the tubes so you can see all them. All of them, look at that. It's really, really nice. Well, too shame I'm not into tubes, but yeah. Maybe I'll take it really apart in the next video. Yeah, scrap the metal, keep the capacitors and the big resistors and the transformers. Maybe some experiments with the tubes. Maybe some X-ray experiments. Well, yeah. So I'll save that for another video. Running out of time right now. So if you have some information about this radio, you know some more about tubes, or you want to discuss it, you can do that beneath this video. Then if you like it, give it a big thumbs up and subscribe if you want to see more teardowns. I have more vintage stuff, some other interesting stuff, so yeah. Well, see you next time. Thanks for watching.